Request Honorable Chancellor Sir and Sheetal Aditya Ma'am to please come forward. Sir, she believes that she is the ambivalent, assiduous, emotional, nature lover, ardent novel reader and loves to amongst loved ones. These are her few words to describe her. She is a team player. She has handled teamwork and leadership responsibilities. And Madam by qualification is BSc Chemistry and MBA. She is a relationship officer at American Express. Also, she is head of the department BMM in Tilak College of Science and Commerce. Thank you, ma'am.
With the grace of Almighty, wishing everybody a warm, bright and a hot afternoon. This opportunity, it's a big honor for me because to present in front of a huge galaxy of intellects, it gives me great honor indeed. And I would like to thank a lot of people who've made it possible for me to be here. And my topic which I need to focus today is my humble effort which I have put across, because as a topic which I am going to present, it has made me very curious to know that how technology can change today's life, not only in terms of healthcare, in various sectors of array of human development. So to start with my presentation topic here on wearable technology, this concept of wearable technology, I think it is not new for you all. But the concept of wearable technology that I'm going to focus upon is how this concept of wearable technology can be induced in education today. We all intellects of teachers here, where technology is the talk for the day. Everything we deal with today is all technology and internet. So I thought about why can't this wearable technology be in a positive aspect of development in human growth and progress. Why can't this be a focus of education today? So talking about what made me curious about taking this topic is like, where do I press? This is innovative, it's not changing. So wearable technology as a concept is the future of accessorizing. Now when I talk about wearable technology, it is just like a mere essential jewelry that you're wearing today. I hope you've heard about something called as Google Glass, which is so famous today that it's been valued in dollars. But if you talk about USA, 61% of the population is using Google Glass, not only in terms of healthcare, but also in terms of education also. It has got a market of around 12 billion. That would be in the forecast for 2018. That is what has been said. This is certain statistics that I thought of would focus that how this wearable technology is being induced in India. Going back. Yes. Okay. This is the statistics which talks on a global perspective that how, for example, I need you to focus only on India. If you see that, only in the past 1 year, this is about million technology penetration on global perspective. If you talk about India, in the span of 1 year, it has increased 41%. That's, you can understand that how technology is going to penetrate into India. Now, this is one picture which I thought of where I could focus on that. If you see, this is a St. Peter Square. If you see 2005 people visiting there, now 2013 people visiting there with all cameras and technology being used across. This is a statistic which talks about the internet penetration. That's in billions. Now, if you talk about Mumbai, all the metropolitan cities I talk about is only an increase in millions. That's how internet is going to take us forward. Now, why do you think this rate of technology is growing? I feel that because it's a positive science. It has given us, a progress, growth and development in all era. Yes. It has become a necessity today. Today, if you talk about a competitive advantage, it's only technology which can take us ahead. Availability, yes. Globalization, when I talk about, it brings across the availability of technology with us. Reduction in cost constraints, yes, absolutely. I think the most important part that has led to the growth of technology is the last point, which I have broad font is that customization of technology for the reduction in man's effort, time, etc. I think this as the reason that has made technology more advanced in our aspect of human development. Yes. Yes, these are few wearable technology that I wanted to focus across. There's a smartwatch. Smartwatch, I think you would have heard, where it focuses on the healthcare sector, on measuring heartbeat of the patient. Yes, used more widely in healthcare sector. This is the shoe sense, the shoe. It's basically an inbuilt sensor in your shoe, which can help you to track your heart, the way you walk, the movements. How much, for example, if it is incorporated with your Google Map, it can help you to understand which right to take, which left to take, where is the destination, how much time would it take. Now, there's more positive aspect that I feel about this technology is like this shoe sense, that the shoe that I'm, the picture which is shown, it has the capacity that the energy that you generate, it has a capacity even to charge your cell. Yes, the next one. Now, a few characteristics which I wanted you to focus, that is in terms of a computerized technology for everyday fashion. Everyday, it's like you're just wearing your jewelry, bare essential like your shirt, your watch, just like it just customized with your day-to-day aspect. And it requires only certain computing support, that's your user's hand, voice, eyes, arms, yes, for engaging for physical environment. Yes, next. These are a few examples that I have quoted again. Yes. Okay, this is certain pool survey which was conducted, which shows that how wearable technology has been accepted in the society. 46 for smartwatches, 42 for glasswares, that's Google Glass. Yes, 52% are interested in any wearable technology you talk about, making them simpler for use and effort. Yes, so it's going to be leveraging in all sectors. If you talk about technology, biometrics, communication, and it is growing. Yes. Now, this, how does the wearable technology come into picture? Where did it evolve? Yes, to start with, I like to show a photo. This is Queen of Naples. She basically was the first to be using, to be claimed in history, to be using a wearable watch, which she was wearing it to be claimed as the first user of wearable technology. Queen of, that's in the 18th century, 1810. Yes, this is a very interesting person. He used a wearable technology in sense of for cheating in casinos. He used to hide it in the packet of cigarettes. And in the shoes, these used to wearable technology in terms of for cheating in casino. So the history of wearable technology starts from a casino cheating, now to a consumer. Yes, more interesting, Kevin Warwick. I think this is one important person I'll mention for all ladies. He's a threat to us because he has devised a wearable necklace where he has tested on his wife, where it attaches to a nervous system where by the color of the necklace, you can understand what's your wife's mood. So we can understand if it's a red light, you can understand, please handle with safety. Yes? Yes, this is one of the first wearable technology that was used. Wristwatch, which was in the 19th century, it was developed, a calculator wristwatch, which was one of the recommendations where President Fort wanted to use this. But it is highly expensive. I think it will be a joke for me to use this, he said that. Yes, the shoe sense, which I was going to talk about more, the Google Glass, the smartwatch. Yes. Yes, I told you about the shoe technology, the shoe sense, which when, for example, if I said, I give an example of, if it is embedded with Google Maps, it can tell you the ways, where to reach, how to meet your friends, your destination, yes. 13 different patterns of running can be monitored by this shoe. Yes? You can understand, for example, a teacher who is teaching physical education. if this technology is embedded in his laptop or in his PDA, in his iPad, and he can monitor every student's heart rate, running speed, and everything, you can understand how much a student should focus on running, walking, and all this. You can help students in terms of, you can understand any deformity the student is having while breathing or heartbeat and all that. We can basically understand if this is included. Yes, is the shoe sense technology, which is embedded with your mobile phone. Yes. Now, the most important part is how it can basically help in transforming our education sectors. I think it is a big yes. The one of the few elements which I feel that it will help in transforming education sector is that this wearable technology can bring about a lot of creativity and transformity in terms of learning and teaching as well. It can basically help students in communication, problem solving. It can help in lifelong learning. Because in classroom, I feel that there's only a two-way dialogue that we can understand. Where, for example, if you can understand a class where you can visually sit in a situation to understand what that process is, the learning is much better. For example, if I want to make them understand what is a nuclear reaction, if I can make them go through a process of a nuclear reactor somewhere, through a Google Glass, through some wearable technology, the learning can be more simpler and more effective. Yes, the most prominent one, the Google Glass. Yes, it gives you experimental learning. That's I gave you an example where you can make the students have a live experience of the situation of whatever you're teaching across. It's coming. Yes, it removes all boundaries between community and society. You are not only bounded to one class, you can get connected to different classes altogether, different experts giving you comments on the same on the same concept. It can give you a vital experience of the knowledge. Yes, augmented reality, you can have a live camera image. Isn't it like a medical student, you just scan across a body to find out where the stomach is, where the appendix is, which aperture to take across. I have a very funny image that I like to show you. Yes, the doctor is asking Google Class, can you tell me where the appendix is while doing an operation? This is why I feel what would be the terms in terms of medical terms, yes? Yes. One of the important wearable technology which can make a change is the autographer. This is a wearable camera. This can help students in basically recording lectures. For example, if there's no possibility of taking direct notes, they can capture live videos, photos together, which can be repeated for their learning sessions and all that. Yeah, just clip it, wear it, and mount it. You can understand where it all can be mounted across during lectures, during group discussion that happens across. Yes. It can capture notes, direct notes from the teachers. Exact information can be catered across. Yes, a spontaneous and a hand-free image can be captured across. Yes. This key gloves, this basically is a tool which can be used for all these physically handicapped children for basically imaging, design, all this can be a technology which can be used in terms of science. Yes, useful for physically handicapped children. Sensors all across for design, data entry, control, 3D objects and all that. Yes. Muse, I think this is one of the most innovative wearable technology that I like to focus. It's like just like a hair band where the students wear across, we can monitor their brain activity. Any task given to them, we can understand whether the student is interested or not interested, or what focus area should I feel across. That's very, very important to understand this. Now, psychological significance. Today, if I feel students are going through a lot of stress, are having, for example, just recently, one of my students, she committed suicide because of stress. At the age of a second year BCom student, out of stress, she committed suicide. We cannot understand today's children's psychology. We cannot understand their mental state. I think this Muse, through a data that is generated by the medical, their brain activity, I think to an extent, we as teachers can monitor. Yes, it can motivate you. Yes, it can basically respond to stress that you have across, giving you a self-control, improves your emotional state. Yes, all these philosophy, consultancy that we do across, we can monitor all through these devices. Yes, next please. Displays the brain activity directly on your smartphone or your tablet. You can understand, for example, any activities being given to you, you can understand where the student's interest lies and you can focus on those important points. Yes. Next please. Now, there are a lot of other wearable technology which I wanted to focus. I think this would have been sufficient enough. Now, the conclusion to all this is that the points I have written, it is hassle-free. It basically, there are some loopholes I feel across would be there to understand that this technology will definitely invade your privacy. But the most important point that I want to focus about, if this wearable technology progresses, I feel the role of teachers in near future is a big question mark. I think we would be, I don't know, I don't want to lose my job, but I feel that this wearable technology, if used in a positive way, can immensely change the learning and the teaching process altogether, because today is a world of technology. I think we should change according to that. But I'm really doubtful that the role of teachers would be an immense role as it is today, right now. So I thank you so much for all your valuable time listening to me. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Please come here.
Thank you.
You would like to avoid